So in sterile processing, we're responsible for the decontamination, assembly, and re-sterilization of all reusable medical instruments. I'm Ashley Hammer. I'm the sterile processing manager here at Washington Regional. So one of the more challenging things is not a lot of people know what an SPD tech is, or even that, you know, we exist. So we're the behind the scenes folks that kind of help keep everybody running. Sterile processing is the backbone of the surgical services. We're the first line of defense for patients.
Hi, my name is James Roundtree. I'm the Vice President of Surgical Services at Washington Regional Medical Center. Without a sterile processing department, a hospital that has any kind of surgical program, you would not be able to function. Without sterile processing, we would come to a screeching halt in about a day. Being a level 2 trauma center, we're required to have surgery 24/7, and without sterile processing, we couldn't have surgery at all.
It's kind of a cycle, so it's we get it dirty and we return it clean, so everything will come into decontam. And in decontam, we will actually clean each individual instrument by hand. So once we clean everything by hand, then we put them into big automatic washers and we run them for about 30 minutes. And then on the other side, there's another door that opens. We'll take them out and then we will reassemble the trays following a list that we have on our computers. And from there, they go into either the sterilizer, or if it doesn't go into that, it goes into the low temperature, which we use hydrogen peroxide to sterilize it with. It just depends. If it's a fragile instrument that can't be exposed to heat, it'll go in the low temperature. From there, then we will load them onto our cart and return them to wherever they go.
We do about between 900 and 1,000 cases a month. So we're a very busy OR. We're one of the busiest ORs in the state. We're definitely the busiest OR in Northwest Arkansas.
So we're the only hospital in the area to require our techs to be CRCST certified. And that sets us apart. So the other hospitals that require that kind of thing are hospitals like Mayo Clinic, MD Anderson, Johns Hopkins. So it's a pretty big deal, and it's great. It's amazing to have our techs to be certified.
And we require perfection. You don't want any instrument set to not have what you need in case of an emergency. So they have a lot of pressure on them, and to do that and to have a good attitude and work hard, and it's just, they're a remarkable group of people.
October 11th through the 17th is Sterile Processing Week, and I recently petitioned Governor Hutchinson to actually declare a proclamation that recognizes Sterile Processing Week for not just our techs here, but all techs in Arkansas, just to give them some recognition and special thanks for what they do.
I would like to say happy Sterile Processing Week to my sterile processing team. I appreciate everything you guys do every day, and surgery we can't do what we do without you. You're just so important to all of us, and to the patients and to the physicians, and we appreciate you, and we just want to say happy Sterile Processing Week.